Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we're talking about P2096 engine codes. A P2096 engine code is going to read post-catalyst fuel system trim 2-lean bank 1. Ultimately, what that means is that the downstream oxygen sensor or the oxygen sensor located after the catalytic converter is detecting that the air-to-fuel ratios are too lean, meaning that we have too much air relative to the amount of fuel that we should have. The good news with the P2096 engine code is that probably sounds a little bit worse than it is. This generally pretty easy problem to diagnose or fix, but in this video, what I'm going to go ahead and do is talk to you a little bit about oxygen sensors and how they work with the catalytic converter so that you understand what the various different components of this system are, so that we can then walk through a list of potential causes that can cause a P2096 engine code, and then take that from there into a diagnostic step list or checklist that you can follow down to go ahead and determine what the actual problem might be. So with that being said, let's go ahead and talk just briefly about oxygen sensors, the catalytic converter, and how the downstream oxygen sensor plays a role in this 2096 engine code. The catalytic converter is the most important emissions component on a vehicle. What it does is take your dirty exhaust gases, pass them through this catalytic converter, and then they come out on the other side more clean than they went through. To be able to measure the effectiveness of a catalytic converter, we put an oxygen sensor before the catalytic converter, and then we put an oxygen sensor after the catalytic converter. It's called an oxygen sensor because what it does is it reads the amount of oxygen that's in the air. What we're able to do is read how much oxygen there is before the exhaust gases get cleaned and how much there is after they get cleaned. And that essentially tells us how good of a job our catalytic converter is doing. And so how that relates to this P2096 is ultimately what this second oxygen sensor is telling us is that there is too much oxygen in this air relative to how much fuel there should be. So there's too much oxygen, which ultimately you might say, hey, that's a good thing. Maybe it sounds like my catalytic converter is doing its job and it's cleaning, you know, the air really well. Well, ultimately there's gonna be a lot of particulates and fuel related vapors that are left over even after passing through the catalytic converter. And so that's why we can read oxygen levels relative to fuel levels is because we don't have clean, pure 100% oxygen coming out of the catalytic converter. With that being said, when it comes down to this engine code and these symptoms, there's really two main things that we're looking at, and that's going to be the catalytic converter and the oxygen sensors themselves. But there are a few caveats to that, so let's go ahead and talk a little bit about causes of P2096 engine codes. The most common cause is going to be an exhaust leak coming somewhere before that downstream or second oxygen sensor. If there's anywhere from the exhaust manifold all the way down to that point where there's an exhaust leak occurring, you're gonna have a ton of clean oxygen entering through and being sucked into the exhaust system before or after the catalytic converter, before this oxygen sensor. And that's gonna cause your oxygen levels to spike because we're pulling clean air in and a lot of the dirty exhaust gases are escaping and passing out through that exhaust leak. From there, it could be a faulty oxygen sensor or a catalytic converter that is bad or is starting to go bad. That's where I want to go ahead and break things off here and talk about issues that can also cause a P2096, but that aren't an issue with one of those components. What I mean by that is it's possible to get a P2096 engine code along with a number of other engine codes. A common one would be something like a P0171, which is also going to tell you that you're running too lean AFRs, but something like a P0171 is actually upstream of these oxygen sensors down here. And so if we're getting a P0171, it means that the issue is likely somewhere on the engine side of things, and that's what's causing us to get the P2096 all the way on the downstream. And so it's really important here to look at what other engine codes you might possibly have, because if you do have something like a P0171, then you're going to want to start looking at the engine with respect to air and fuel. So you want to check for vacuum leaks. You want to make sure your fuel system is good, that your fuel injectors are good. You want to make sure you don't have any air leaks on the intake side of things, that your PCV system is working, and that your mass airflow sensor is good and getting good air readings. So if you have a P0171 or another engine code that takes place at the actual engine, then it's likely the case that the 2096 code is an effect of this other code. And so in that case, you'll want to be looking at and diagnosing the P0171 instead of trying to diagnose the P2096. With that being said, we do have some videos on P0171s. Another common one that you can get is a P0420, which we've done a video on before too, which relates to the catalytic converter. So now let's talk about a diagnostic step list here. The first thing is going to be to read all of your engine codes and make sure you don't have anything else on there that looks like it might be an issue, because like I mentioned, then we're gonna need to diagnose a completely different set of things than we are here. Assuming you just have a P2096, there's gonna be three things like I mentioned, and so the best route to go here is from easiest to hardest in terms of testing. The first thing is to check for exhaust leaks. If your engine's running, it's pretty easy to climb underneath the vehicle, and obviously don't touch the exhaust pipes because they're extremely hot, but you should be able to feel underneath them, and you should feel air coming out if you have an exhaust leak anywhere. You'll also likely notice a louder exhaust tone. And then from there, you'll want to go ahead and find both of the oxygen sensors, inspect the oxygen sensors. You can go ahead and actually remove them and take a look at them, because you might be able to easily spot that they're bad or not. And then if your oxygen sensors look good and you don't think you have any issues there, the next up is going to be testing the catalytic converter, which is a little bit more technical of a process, but there are ways to check the catalytic converter and make sure that that's operating properly. I will say that if your catalytic converter is completely bad, you're probably going to get a P0420 engine code with it. If it is starting to go bad, you might just get the P2096. And so it can be a little bit hard to tell whether the catalytic converter is the problem or not. At that point, you know, you might have to look up a video on how to do more advanced catalytic converter testing, or take it somewhere to have them run a test on it to make sure your catalytic converter is good. But I will say, like I mentioned, the majority of the time you're gonna have an exhaust leak somewhere within your exhaust system. So that's where I would really focus and spend my time on, is looking for one of those. All right, well, that covers it for a video on P2096 engine codes. I hope this video was helpful in helping you diagnose what's going on with your car. If you guys found this video helpful, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future content.